What's going on, my friends? Chris here. I want to bring you all a quick update. Just a video I had on my mind, and what I wanted to talk about were the five things I learned in 2021. So I started my trading journey back in 2017 in the crypto space. Before that, I never did anything in the stock market. I would just flip stuff on Craigslist, weight equipment. I'm a personal trainer and a specialist in fitness nutrition. So I was running that business, and I would just buy weight equipment that people wanted to get out of their house, and I was trying to flip it. And then all of a sudden I started learning about Bitcoin and Ethereum, and it just really piqued my interest. And I said, you know, if other people have been able to do this, if I study hard, I work hard, I should be able to do this, and I'm still getting in early. So I really started studying that stuff. And what I learned during that time and in 2021 here, most importantly, is that I made the most money when I was buying the fear. Now, it's important with Bitcoin to really know what the fear is, because many times you'll have a leg down and then all of a sudden you think that's the bottom, and your relative strength on the one day you'll be at, say, 25, and you'll go, oh, this is the bottom, I'm gonna nail it. And all of a sudden you go in and then you'll have a whole nother leg to the downside. So what I've learned is to be extremely patient and ladder into those positions. So let's just do something easy. Say you're gonna play a $1,000 position. I'll start looking at these lower areas, and I'll start with $100 here, and then another $100 lower, and then 100, then 100, and 100. And I'll just layer them in as the price is going down, so I get a nice average for when we do reverse out of there, because we always do, and we start moving to that upside, and that's when I'm going to sell into strength. So buying the fear for me in 2021 was my best trades. I had my best day on the day that we had. It was back in May when we lost, what was it, guys, 30 or 40% in a day, the China stuff. That was my best day because I basically nailed the bottom, and on that same day, I sold once we bounced up. So I caught the very lowest point of that wick, and I rode it up for the day, you know, 20 or 30%, whatever it was, and then I sold it off, and then it started going back down again. So in the same day, I was able to have one of my best days, and that was buying the fear. So buying the fear and selling into the greed. It doesn't matter. You don't need to nail the top. Jesse Livermore always talked about the first or the bottom eighth of a market, and the top eighth of a market is where most people go broke. We want to get that big meat of the move is what we're looking for. So that's number one. Number two, coins don't need solid fundamentals to go up in price. And this is something that I really, you know, I've been in space 4 years, whatever, and I never could have imagined Dogecoin would have been in the top 10. So, you know, I've learned how to just play those pumps and take it for what it is and day trade those opportunities, use stop losses, and really take advantage of that volatility. So I'm not long-term investing in those things, but I will trade the hype and just the pump, the euphoria. I will trade that now, as opposed to just saying, you know, I want nothing to do with it. Now I'll trade it, I'll protect myself and try to rip out some profits from it and not long-term invest in it. But, you know, that's something I learned, that meme coins, they can fly. So definitely something I learned there. That was the second one. The third one was cutting losses short. Now this is something that I did really well in 2021. If I was wrong on something, I'd either get stopped out or I would just cut it pretty quick. I didn't take any big losses, so that was a blessing. And I've just learned that if I'm wrong, which I'm going to be in this space, you have to accept being wrong, just cut it as fast as possible. And then the next thing I learned was to let my winners run. So to always use a trailing stop loss and let it go as far as possible, as opposed to just trying to sell out at the top and then all of a sudden it goes up another 20-30%. So I also like to layer out as well, or let a trailing stop loss take me out. So that's very important. The next one for me, and this kind of goes into what we were just talking about, is stops are a must. And also the next thing is stay out of sideways markets. So when it's going sideways, if you're just trying to trade in there, it'll really chop you up. Really just wait for trends, either bullish or bearish, and trade the trends as opposed to trying to trade the ranges. That can get sticky, and sometimes support won't hold or resistance will break, and it's just back and forth, a lot of chop. So when Bitcoin's going sideways, I just like to trade stocks or look somewhere else as opposed to trying to get chopped up in there. I've done that before, trying to be stubborn and fighting a downtrend and trying to buy the exact bottom and just fighting it. I don't do that anymore. I just really try to wait for the trend to change, or I'll use it as a short-term trade. Say we get, you know, a big drop down on the 1 hour time frame and the relative strengths at 10 or 12, I will buy that and I'll sell into the strength, that bounce, even if it's a weak one, I'll sell into it and just take the percent that I can. So I'm not trying to be greedy. I'm not trying to hit home runs. I'm trying to hit singles, doubles, and if you hit a home run, that's great. But these were some of the things I learned in 2021, and I hope it helps you out, guys. God bless you all. Take care.